He tries to keep, but instead it is Paul Gay to Galley, and here we go, Jay Miller and Dave Brown, and this is the renewal of virtually every season, with Miller knocking the helmet off Brown, who comes in with the left, crosses.
Wow. You want to talk about some punches landing? A couple of big ones there for both Jay Miller and Dave Brown. There have not been any teeny-weeny fights tonight, gang. They've been all major leaguers and big ones. All the heavyweights. And finally, the heavyweights of heavyweights get into it. Dave Brown and Jay Miller. Miller really got the jump on that, Mike. I didn't see how it started. It was right down in front of us, almost too close to being under us.
Off the glass, out of his left wing corner, and into the seats. And now we got Dave Brown and Perry Anderson.
The interesting part of it was Anderson made sure that he was trying to keep Brown from getting in the zone, and he ended up just dropping his gloves and going at it. Perry Anderson's a game player. He acquired it from St. Louis, and he'll stick his nose in there on anyone. But now they've got to calm down. As Brown goes to the penalty box, being escorted by Pat Tafuzzo, and Perry Anderson is being held away by John D'Amico, and it'll be, it looks like he might be going to the dressing room.
Young came out, let the puck hit him. Now Cochran can't find the handle. Craven in front, his shot, and Young covered that one. As Cochran turned left, the puck went right. Flyers dig it out of that right board. Now behind the net, Craven in front, and it scoots right past. Now we got a, oh, we got a $10. Cochran and Brown. Cox, is it?
Yes, it's Cox and Brown. Boy, I'll tell you, Cox or Brown is really landing some left punches on young Craig Cox. And it started, of course, you could see something going to happen, Gene, as there was a couple of checks thrown at some of the smaller Flyers, and quickly Brown was sent out on the next ship.
Well, I said, remember Coxie's Army was looking for a little battle there. And, all right, they'll get majors and maybe more with 8:47 remaining in regulation from Vancouver. Flyers 6 and Vancouver 1.
Oh, he's beating up pretty good. I'll tell you, it happened in the corner. Flyers trying to control the puck inside the zone. Cox took a run at Dave Brown. Brown saw him coming. They got their sticks up high. Then they both dropped their gloves and went at it. And then Brown landed a number of shots. Cut him, Craig Cox, over the eye. Cox got a couple of shots in, but it didn't seem to be too much damage done to Dave Brown. Cox has gone to the Vancouver dressing room to get repairs. But they both pick up majors for fighting.
For Ron Hextall, as the shot from the point save, and now we got Probert, who and Brown, we knew we were eventually going to get at this, as it's the final meeting and the final 15 seconds of the year between these two clubs, unless they meet for the Stanley Cup final. And so Brown and Probert are giving their final calling cards. Probert, who went off in the second period and a mile set to with Scott Bellenby for five, not much has happened here as they're taking a nameless punch here now. Brown's got Probert's helmet off. He's got the shirt over his head, partially to throw, but Probert's very strong and won't release either of Brown's arms. So they're doing the waltz me around again, Willie, along the near side. And because of their size and strength and potential danger, neither Wayne Bonney, the helmeted linesman, or the veteran Jerry Gauthier, looking at you now on the far side of the combatants, are able to get in until just about now. They will not go to the penalty boxes. We'll wax about this game, my friends, for time to come. Having played the same number of games, each with 19 remaining, and the Flyers will get a chance to see the next game of the Washington Capitals in Los Angeles tomorrow night. Probert again and Dave Brown. As the scoreboard here shows the carnage that the Flyers have wreaked against the Detroit.
They just took around one look at each other and dropped it. Brown has really got a height advantage over Kevin Dineen. Dineen's only 5'10", Brown 6'5". And now Brown is trying to keep him away so he can get some punches, and Dineen has not thrown one yet.
Ramage keeps it in. Shot smothered. It's dumped in deep, and now we got another fight. Ross Fitzpatrick and Pavese again, and that's a bear hug. Fitzpatrick trying to get the left arm free. Pavese and Fitzpatrick in a bear hold. Is that, though, that's Dave Brown, excuse me. Now the helmet is off Brown. They're in a bear hug still. Pavese has his helmet on. wrestlers, Greco-Roman wrestlers hold now above the waist. Round the head.
And up the middle, going in all around. Shot by Prop. Oh, what did it hit the post?
Yep.
Oh, it came out so cleanly. And Prop. Oh, now we got Willannon and Brown.
Brown's shot on the rebound is the one that hit the post, and then he and Willannon went right after each other after that shot. You can hear Chico Riss and Ron Hogarth having a few heated words.
We sort out obvious penalties. We have 5:40 remaining second period from the Metadon.
Right in on Resch. He hit the goalpost dead on, and then the rebound came out of Brown. Got a good shot away, and Resch recovered very well and made the nice save. That's when Willannon and Brown pushed at each other, dropped the gloves, and went at it. And they pick up 5-minute majors for fighting.
Willannon on the air now.
Well, here we have Dave Brown and John Kordick, as we had been able to predict from the stoppage of play.
Ooh, Dave
a couple
Brown.
Of southpaws. Boy, Brown was really going for the left uppercut there too, wasn't he?
Dave Brown has a decided reach advantage, and he really locked John Kordick out. Now look what he's got. He's got his hand held behind him. When you talk heavyweights, folks, you're talking these two guys. What a great battle, stand-up battle all the way. Well, Dave Brown said his role was pretty simple in the Flyers organization, and it looks like John Kordick has a bloody nose. You bet he does. So my role is simple. If there's a problem on the ice, I go out and fix it. There's a little earlier. Here's how it started. They just went out to the point together, and then it was a matter of, okay, let's not ask any questions. We kind of figured it would happen. Oh, Kordick just put his head down without getting a grip first. Boy, oh boy. And you can, I think he's already been hit. Dave Brown might have hit him with the first one or two punches right in the nose with those uppercuts.
Ooh, he was really trying to score with that one as he pulled away, wasn't he?
Yeah, but John Kordick, well, you know, as soon as he put his head down, he really couldn't see what he was grabbing or where he was grabbing. And this is when Dave Brown, now, do you think that's not a tough position to be in? Got a half Nelson on him at the same time, but still facing him. You can see that Dave Brown has him locked out so well. Kordick's punches weren't coming with...
along with Hackburn and Richie Sutter. That really created an awful lot.
Flyers have picked up in the shots department, have outshot LA 7-3 so far in the second period. Darryl Sittler going against Wes Jarvis, loose in the slot. Dave Brown there, Jarvis tries to clear, and there we go. Dave Brown and Anders Håkansson, and now we have a big melee. I think some of the Kings came in to rescue Håkansson, who really had no chance.
Well, Brown got Jarvis down. I think it's Håkansson, Eddie. It's Cochran that's got one of them down on the ice, pulled the jersey over, and you can see the linesman getting it involved as Brown down on top of one of the officials, right down the ice. But that big guy has got a reputation in the American League that he likes to go and he can go and doesn't hesitate. And that's exactly what happened here. And it's kind of stirred things up here in the Spectrum with a small, sparse crowd here due to weather conditions. Have all of a sudden become a rather noisy, rambunctious crew. Wes Jarvis should be Wes Jarvis should be third man in. We'll have to get out, but there is a rule that it states that if that doesn't apply, when you see it right there, here's Håkansson, and actually it was Brown. Ooh, Brown hit him with two lefts that put him right down. That's when Jarvis came in to grab Brown. Now it's up to set up Thomas Erickson. He makes a dandy of a move to the forehand to go around the rookie Brian Kern and beat Pete Peters on the ice to the short side. Now we have a fight. Glenn Cochran and Chris Rolisky are going at, or pardon me, Dave Brown, before the faceoff even started. Both of them dropped their gloves and went at each other. Now you've got a couple of big players going at each other, and they threw a couple of real haymakers. So the Flyers scoring a goal, and Brown and Chris Rolisky picking a fight, or maybe Kluzak, Gordy Kluzak will be
taking time out for this message. Give you the goal first. Thomas Erickson picks up his 10th of the year. Bobby Clark and Ronnie Sutter, the assist at 409. And the penalty.
But Brown, and I guess Partner again, and they go down heavily in that corner. Caulfield make that. Oh, Brown burying him. Oh! Mr. Caulfield, you are the first National Hockey Leaguer from the Philadelphia area to play in a game at the Spectrum, and you did that Thursday, but you're getting hammered, my friend, right now. As Dave Brown, for the second time in the game, he and Caulfield went at it. They each got five for fighting at 10:40 of the second period. Caulfield also got an instigation call. Two heavyweights. One might have to give the decision there to Dave Brown.
The corner. Prop is there. Prop is hit along the boards by James Patrick. Beck. It's poked.
There they go. There they go. Two big guys.
Beck and Brown. Barry Beck and Dave Brown.
And I'll tell you, I saw that coming all the way. And Beck is mad, and there's no way you're going to stop him now. And Brown is one heck of a fighter. And that started way back. And I don't think we've seen the last of that tonight either.
Well, you know Beck isn't thinking about the shoulder.
Off wing in front. Oh, a turnaround shot by Ron Sutter. Almost got through it. We're now going to have a penalty. And then Reggie Lemelin did a turn as if he were hit across the face. And we're going to have ugliness. Now it's Baxter and Tockett finally gotten free.
What happened is Ronnie Sutter hit.
Oh, Baxter was buried by Tockett. And he goes down into the turtle. He got one right in the Labanza, and he's down.
What happened was Ronnie Sutter bumped Reggie Lemelin behind the net. They went after Ronnie Sutter. That's when everybody came in. And Baxter and Tockett paired off.
But boy, he got him right on the button. And Baxter went down and Tockett, unsure whether he was playing turtle or hurt, took a shot in the ribs, and that meant with a large round of displeasure here. But Baxter's up now saying, where's the truck? But that point, the game turned just a bit ugly. Now Bob Johnson is asking Pep Linsky, make sure you go over. And now Terry Gregson saying to Brad Marsh, no. So Baxter will go off, I'm sure. And Tockett will go off, and we'll see what else happens. But Baxter's jawing at the Flyer bench, but I don't know what he's pointing about. He just got KO'd.
Well, he's at home. So he has to make sure that that his image is kept up.
Remember Hank Boucher getting...
The Flames came very close to getting back, and how drilled Popinski, who really he was diving over to the fallen goaltender Jensen so that he wouldn't hit him.
Well, now he got it.
Brown along with Popinski. I started that one. I don't know, but Popinski's receiving an awful lot from Dave Brown. I don't know what really started that one.
Well, the goal at 12:55 for Philadelphia. These penalties coming at 13:14. But Popinski took a pounding there. And again, neither I nor Bobby saw what precipitated the confrontation.
Well, Popinski was the one who ended up in the net. Something must have been said. Again, we're going to have a discussion. I wonder if referees take a course in international relations.
Rob Ray and Brown want to have a few punches at it. I think the Lions are going to let him go. 6'5", 210-pound Dave Brown along with Rob Ray. And it's WWF time of the wrestling match. Ray's got to get a couple of punches in close, which he's doing. Popped off that skid lid of Brown, and here goes the tearaway equipment for Rob Ray. Sweater comes off. Brown gets the windmills going. Brown's got the Hogan tearaway equipment. Look at these punches being thrown. Dave Brown and Rob Ray. Who can get their clothes off the fastest?
Oh, they should tie each other up with a jersey.
Oh, big hit by Ray.
A big right hand.
That's a stunner. Back, right, back. The clothes are off.
think we have to give him the decision on this one.
Absolutely. We'll get a chance to see the big punch by Rake. As Paul Stewart just let him go, and the laundry comes off as well.
Now there was a great right hand thrown in this fight by Rod Ray. That catches Brown right on the cheek.
I don't know where he gets the chance to fire
the punch. There it is, right there. There's
the
right hand. That was a dandy right.
In any event, that is over with. The closer back.
Wade King and Domi on for the Rangers. Himself moving it past Domi, who slammed into the boards. And ready to drop the gloves with Boyman. Brown steps in. Here they go.
You know, Domi went to slash the stick of Roussel, and Boyvin nailed Domi from behind, knocking Domi head first, or at least shoulder first, into the boards. And Big Dave Brown's got the left hand going. And is he tough? Domi has the long reach to come back with, and Domi can't get his left hand free. One-sided win for Dave Brown. I don't think this one's over for the night, Sam. Domi, I think, was partially stunned with the hit from Boyvin knocking Domi into the boards. And Domi went up to go with Boyvin. And at the same time, Dave Brown stepped in. And Dave Brown, I think he's the best at that business. He showed it.
We'll be right back. Doesn't want to leave. He gets 5 minutes for fighting and a 10-minute misconduct, and he deserved it.
Well, he got 10 minutes because as he was going to the penalty box, Ryan McGill skated by, and Ty reached out and pushed him into the boards on the way to the penalty box. So that was enough for Gregson to give him the 10-minute misconduct. Now watch the hit here. As Domi moves in, he goes down with the stick, and now he goes, as you see, heavily into the boards. Now he turns around and sees Boyvin, and he wants to go Boyvin. Now Brown comes in. And Brown ties up Domi's left hand. And Dave Brown is a left-handed fighter himself, and is he tough? And he showed it.